These are just a click away, so they are still there, but they're much more colourful, much more engaging, and easier to drill and find out information and ask questions of. So we'll start off by looking at the conduct dashboard, which is drawing a bunch of information together about behaviour that's been entered into the system by the teachers. Now you have to see how that works to believe how simple it is. It's a beautiful interface of all the pupils on a single screen, enter the information, two clicks, Natasha's going to show you that, stick around for it. But this is where the data ends up. And down here on the left, I've set this system up for other demonstration purposes. I'm actually a class teacher of 4SL. So different types, starting with class participation, good working class. These are completely configurable by you, and so are the point scores, or you can take the ones that come out of the box. We've got this broken down by key groups for us. So what's our behaviour by boys, by girls, by EAL, preschool meals, not preschool meals, in care, and so on. I've zoomed that a little bit too much, let me zoom that out. And I will take that tick off because we've got rather a lot of red attendance on there. We're probably going to have to do something about that. So we've got the summary attendance statistics for the school here. You can see whether these are trending up or trending down. And the colour of these charts, everyone, depends on what you set your KPIs for your school to be. If you want them to be, you know, if you want your attendance target to be 98%, you can just put that in the notes. So our staff vehicle list, I don't know if you spotted it, but on the homepage we are having a school car park resurfaced today. Someone's parked the car on there, we need to know who it is. So we'll just apply that, and that's just going to quickly run out the staff and their registration numbers. We've got to find out who's blocking the school driveway. So there's lots and lots of these list reports in the system for you to get access to.
No colour coding.
There's what I want to show you. So we've got the widgets, we've seen the dashboards and how easy they are to analyse. Let's look at some reports. So within, and I'm not talking about reporting to parents here, although that's a transformed solution in Sims Prime. It's so much easier to use with nice, colourful, bright templates. See the leader dashboard, it draws information together from right across the school and puts it onto one page. So whilst that one takes a little bit of time to draw at the moment, that one. This one, showing me I've got 390 pupils in my school. This is broken down by the key sort of characteristics. Is this trending up and down? Has it changed at all in the last 30 days? We've got the behaviour recorded today. Any staff absences? And it's fighting with the internet there. Should be along at the moment. That's going to be a widget of attendance, which will show me, and here it comes now. And again, we've got some interesting to say looking data. So we've got the attendance in year 6, in year 5, in year 4, in year 3 and so on. This black line marks where the attendance was last year, whether we've got an issue we think we need to investigate. We'll just zoom in on that again and scroll down a bit. We'll go past the main classes if I missed before. This one, it's not great data in it, but our pilot schools really like this widget. It's about mobility. They're saying how many pupils have we had arrive or leave in a given month? So if you're in an area that's challenged in that regard, this widget's telling you the number of leavers and arrivals in Writer's Edge. See that many people see it? At the moment it's showing, I should have changed this before we started, it's showing a count of attendance. It's actually obviously a lot more helpful if it shows the vicinity. So we'll change that. Hopefully that'll refresh up here, and we'll get 100% attendance somewhere in the middle there. Right. So, we've got the top level attendance for the school. And now, if I start by clicking on the school level, it's drilling through to the years. So it's going to go from school level through to the different years that are going to come up on the screen here. There they are. And if we look at the bottom of the screen here, year 6, we click in there, and it's going to drill from school through to years, and now we're going down another layer, and it's going to show us that there are two classes in year 6, and we're going to drill into that data, 6KH and 6BC, and if we want to, we can drill again down to pupil level. So, you know, the dashboards are very interactive, but the surface level, they tend to be graphical. The reports, it's often very much the same sort of impact of absence across the date range that's been set here. it's really, really, really straightforward to run that kind of information out through the library reports. And you can actually filter this for different types of absence if you want to. So let me close that one down. Reports that you want something different. It's not there today. So you can get at the data and design your own report. So it's just a really simple one with a pupil focus. What you get with Siemens Primary, and I'll come to screen in a minute, is a sort of design canvas where you can build the report that you're looking for and see if it's what you want before you print it or do anything with it. So it's put in here by the pupils, and it starts off, it helps you out, it says, okay, I'll put some names there. You can get rid of those in a moment. And you can see